I'm here with the Redmi 7A, the phone that I showed you, phone that you can get for, I think, 75 euros these days, brand new. It's an amazing phone, really. You can install GSI ROMs on this thing, and you can as well install SIP ROMs. There are two very good ROMs, at least LineageOS is pretty good out there. It's not official, it's an unofficial build, but at least Moki has a very good ROM. And I installed Moki, I have Moki running onto this phone right now. So in fact, this is what we're gonna create. We're gonna create, we're gonna update this phone, in fact, to custom, from stock to custom. We're gonna get rid of MIUI. And to even do so, you must first check what the version is that you're running of the MIUI OS. If this is version 11, you will first need to downgrade to 10 before you can even think of doing this. It won't be possible from out 11. In some way, 11 is not allowing that anymore. I don't know. So we'll need to downgrade. Okay, I as well break this phone, and we're gonna go from the part where I break this phone and where I will have to restore this phone first back to MIUI 11, and then we're gonna go into recovery mode, into a fast boot mode. And from out the fast boot mode, we're gonna connect to ADB. That's a tool that you can download to flash, you know, to give commands and push applications to the phone. So we then, in the fast boot mode, we're gonna install Twerp. Okay, that's the procedure. And then we're gonna flash in Twerp the MIUI 10. That as well is being delivered as a recovery file, so you can flash it from out Twerp, okay? But the bad thing is that it will replace the recovery bag for the MIUI recovery. But that is, yeah, that is the procedure. If you're on 11, you will first have to go into fast boot mode, install Twerp, go into Twerp, install MIUI 10, boot the system up, go back to fast boot, flash Twerp again, go into Twerp, and from there, after doing a wipe, you can flash Moki OS, or you can flash Lineage OS, ROMs that are in a SIP format available, recovery ROMs that you can flash from out the recovery. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm as well gonna show you a practical joke from Xiaomi. The flash tool from Xiaomi will let you, you know, lock the device again and restore it, or just, you know, clean it up without locking the device. We're gonna go for the second option because we don't want to go and unlock this thing again. So this all can only be done if you first unlocked this phone. If you don't know how to unlock it, I spoke about it wherever I showed this phone for the first time, but just go to the Xiaomi website and get the unlock tool and follow the procedures there. You know, that is your part. You will have to do that on your own. So after you unlock your phone and you see unlock, you know, whenever you turn it on, then you can come back to this video and follow the steps that I'm gonna show you now. This video is as well for people that bricked their phone and it's hanging in a fast boot mode, and in no way they can go into a recovery mode anymore, and in fact they don't know what to do. They only see some comic figure and they are like, oh my god, what should I do now? So this video is as well for you guys, because you're gonna see the complete picture in this kind of pretty long video. So if you have this phone and you want to do it right in one time, and you don't want to break your phone and go into all the trouble that I went to make this video, then you must watch this video very good, very, very properly. How do you say that? You must watch it from the beginning to the end. At least you must watch it until you understand what's crack-a-lacking, okay? Because if you're gonna break your phone, you cannot come and get your money back here at me. You cannot blame me. If you're gonna do so, I'm gonna start laughing at you, you know? Because you are responsible for everything that you do on your own device. Not because I show it and I show you magics and these other guys, you know, YouTubers that are showing these ROMs, you know, not because it all goes good for them, you know, whenever you make a mistake, you can go and claim your money. Nothing like that. You are responsible for your own yeah, whatever you're gonna do on the phone. If you're ready to rumble, yeah, then we can get started. So welcome to a new install procedure here at Channel 48 Tutorial. My name is Puk and thank you for tuning in. Let's get started. Like to scare people. So there is the phone, it's booting up. I can see that here. You see that it's booting, it's just fine. As you can see, we got the error. It was up to here and then boom, error. Error, not catch checkpoint. Fast boot, lock flash is not done. So this error is only pointing to, you know, to clean and lock. It did not finish the lock part of this flashing. That is what it's saying. It's not saying anything else. So I'm gonna show you how to get started. What you will need is a flash tool. It's called Xiaomi Flash. Here you can see it. It's the latest version that you can get from. Let me see. I closed the website already. Yes, I did. Never mind, but here is the folder that we unpacked. You will get it as a zip. You open it like that, and then you need to browse. Yeah, to browse. There are two sorts of ROMs that you can download, as I found out from Xiaomi. ROMs that you can flash via Flash Tool, or ROMs that you can flash via the recovery. Okay, so in fact you can install Twerp and then, you know, flash certain ROMs from out Twerp. It will go just fine. But it's not about that. The phone is hanging in a fast boot mode. It's not doing anything. It's software bricked and we need to fix it. So what I did, I downloaded the firmware from Xiaomi and then I copied it to my ADB folder. Not that I'm gonna use it from out there, but here it is, Pine EE Global Images, etc. You see the phone is booting up. There's nothing wrong with it. And this is in fact the information that you need. Yeah, this is what this flash tool needs. So the only thing that you need to do is go to the folder, don't open it, and hit OK. That's all you need to do. You see that? So you go to My Computer, C, ADB, you select the folder and then you hit OK. And then the address will come here. You see? Some people, they go and copy the name of the location. They make it so complicated for normal people. Just hit select here and browse the normal way how you always browse to files and select the folder where you have the unpacked MIUI and select it. And then, very important, you unlocked your bootloader, but it will lock it again. You see, it will lock it again. So what you should do is hit clean all. Okay, so it leaves the bootloader unlocked. Otherwise you will need to unlock the bootloader again. It's a complete hassle. You must create account and blah blah blah, all sorts of crap. You know, it's as well a problem when you're gonna sell the phone, eh? When you sell the phone, in fact, you should unlock the bootloader. And you should deliver the device without any account in the device. I'm not sure if that is possible, because I found out that in my MIUI Redmi Note 4, the guy sold it to me with LineageOS. But whenever I want to restore back to MIUI, not that I'm ever gonna do a thing like that, but if I want to do that, it's asking for some password, blah, blah, nonsense, rubbish. And I cannot do that. You see? So you must always make sure when you buy a Redmi Note 4 or any Xiaomi phone that the thing can boot up when you're sitting at the guy from start to the desktop without asking any password after doing a complete reset, wipe of the phone, restore to original. You know, because if there are accounts in there, you're gonna be having a problem afterwards. You will be able to install custom ROMs, but not the official thing anymore. So now you just hit flash, and then the thing will be flashed, and then the phone is getting fixed, and then suddenly you get you see the progress, and then suddenly you see boom, error, and you're like, oh my god, now it happened, the phone is bricked. But that is just a trick from MIUI to scare you, you know, to get you to lock the bootloader again. So that is kind of, yeah, a practical joke from these guys. Okay guys, the phone is fixed and it's booting up, and we can go through the setup procedure. And if you want to be on MIUI 11 and you want to stay on there, then you are done and good to go. And then I wish you a very nice day. But for those that want to install a custom ROM, and for those that want to learn how to downgrade from 11 to 10, well, for you, yeah, you must still follow this class, because now I'm not gonna go through the complete thing here, because this is annoying. I'm just gonna press volume down and power, and then we're gonna go back into a fast boot mode and start with flashing twerp. So what I'm gonna do, I'm done with this because I'm gonna downgrade it. I'm tired of this phone already, so I'm gonna long press until it goes off. We're gonna put it in fast boot mode again. Yeah, unbrick and downgrade. This is how we're gonna call this video. Because this thing make me tired already, man. I'm gonna put it on its head like that. Let me hope that it will stand. Don't you press buttons there. Never mind. We're just gonna flash twerp to it. Okay, let's give this thing a decent recovery. You won't see anything, okay? So I'm just gonna put the phone aside. You don't have to look at everything. You must look at the procedure. So this is the ADB folder. You need ADB for this. And I'm going to hit the shift. And then I can open a command window in here. Yeah. And then we type ADB. Boom. And then we type fastboot. Devices. You see, here it's showing a number. Yeah, and now we as well downloaded the twerp. We unpacked the twerp, and in there we found the recovery. The recovery is called recovery image. You cannot put a zip file twerp. So this is the twerp. When you open it, you unpack the recovery and you copy it to your ADB folder. No, already have it. So you understand? All right, good. So we go back to this window. Here it is. Oh, sorry for that. Can you see it better now? Yes. And now we're gonna type fastboot flash recovery space recovery, because that's the name of the image, dot image. Oops. Okay. Now you're gonna hold the phone in your hand and you're gonna start with holding up. Oh, sorry for that. You're gonna start with holding up volume and put your other finger on the power, okay? But not yet, don't press power, but press volume up. And now you type fastboot reboot, okay? The moment you press enter on your keyboard, you're gonna press power, enter power. We let go of the power and we keep holding the volume up. Don't press too hard, scared to break these buttons, and this should bring us in twerp. Okay, so now we have twerp installed. Now this should as well connect to MTP. All right, so this is very, very nice. I want to downgrade now because I don't like MIUI 11. Because I want to do other things. I want to build a ROM for this, a decent ROM for this phone. This is the Redmi, the internal storage. And I'm gonna paste the MIUI 10. This is a zip file. Okay? So I'm gonna flash it from Outwerp. Just gonna see if it works. And then I'm gonna, you know, upgrade it to Android 10. So I'm downgrading to upgrade to Android 10. We unbricked and then we downgraded and then we're gonna upgrade to Android 10. You understand? So when you're gonna get this phone, and I think now in 2020, it's gonna come with MIUI 11. So then in fact you need to downgrade it. So this is the complete process that I'm showing you. We first unbricked it. And there's only one part that you should do on your own. And that is unlock the bootloader. But that's very simple. Well, it's not simple at all. It's a whole bloody hassle. You need a working 4G SIM card. Really? That's what you need. You need to create a Xiaomi account and a whole lot of things you need to do. But then you get a tool, an unlock tool, and then you must put the phone in a fast boot mode after you know, and then, oh man, it's a complete hassle. I think I made a video about it. You should check it out. I cannot even remember all the steps out of my head. That's how terrible it is. Anyway, so what we're gonna do is just let's just do a normal wipe, okay? Let's see what's gonna happen. Let's do a wipe, a normal wipe. We get no red lines at all. Okay, so let's do a good wipe. Dalvik system, Fender data, and catch, and custom. Okay, now we go back, and we're gonna install the PineRAM, and this is official MIUI. Because this is a nice phone to run Lineage OS onto. And from this 10, I'm gonna make a special version, a light version. But you must be on 10 to be able to install it. So you will have to downgrade. I'm not sure if you can downgrade straight from Outwerp. So if you're on 11, you install Twerp and then downgrade. That's what I'm doing now. So I'm not sure if this will break the phone again or, you know, maybe I need the one that must be flashed with the Mi tool. So I'm not sure if this will work. Because if this works, then I have another RAM for it that I made light that in fact bricked the phone before. But maybe it depended on the bootloader from 10. Because now we downgraded. Let me see if it's gonna flash the other things. Okay. Patching system unconditionally. Patching Fender image. Okay, this looks good. Okay. So what we're now gonna do is we're gonna format data. Yes. And we're gonna reboot again. Do not install. It's booting. So we're booting Android 9, but am I now? What is this? We had Android. This is MIUI 10. We're installing Android, I think 8 now. I'm not even sure. I don't know these MIUI things, you know. This is, I just got this phone, so I don't know all these builds. But I think that MIUI 11 is 9, so MIUI 10 should be 8, I think.
Nope, it's just Android 9, Puck.
And I'm not gonna keep this. I'm just booting it up now to show you that the downgrade worked. And then we're gonna upgrade it to Android 10, but then unofficial Linux OS. Copies? And then you can root it and do all these things. Because I don't like the fact that that I cannot turn off apps. So in fact, I also made a light version, but I think, I'm not sure. It should be good. This one installed fine, but it dependent probably on this one. So probably if I do a wipe data factory reset and I flash my ROM that I created for this phone, then it's gonna be good. It's gonna just flash. So I probably have a custom ROM for this phone already. A custom stock. And then we're gonna stay on there. Because I don't want to install MIUI 11. I'm never gonna use it with MIUI 11. So I think it's not a good idea to install that on it, you know, because I will never use it. Because I don't like the way the operating system deals with me. You know, these things are like, how can you see your phone? You can see your phone like a woman, you know? All respect to woman. I think women can see phones as men too, you know? You have women that listen and they like you and they help you. And you have others that always want to fight you. They always know it better. You know these kinds of relationships. We've all been there before. And you have men that are stubbish, they don't, you know, keep to the promise of the woman. They drive the woman nuts. It's just like a phone. Let's see if I can skip this. I agree. Was already said. Nice, nice. I like that. No, it will not, because Google cannot connect. And then, of course, I can get a big one. So I'm in the jungle now, and yeah, so in fact, it's just gonna, you know, so I'm not planning to do that. So what we're now gonna do, we're just gonna hold down volume. No, what we're gonna do is, let me think. Oh yeah, we're gonna hold volume up, and we're gonna start pressing power. We're just gonna kill the beats. Yeah, man. We boot it up, we let go of power, we keep holding the volume up. And that should bring us in Twerpo, you know? And Twerpo. Twerpo, come on. There we go. Hey! Blood clot, of course, you stupid. Of course. This is very, very normal. We hit reboot, reboot to system, but now with volume down. Yes, we go back to fast boot mode. Of course, of course, of course, of course, my friends. We installed official firmware. Even though it was installed via Twerp, it will brutally replace Twerp. That is very, very, very common sense to understand. If you cannot understand that, then you don't understand. Then that is not good. Fastboot devices, there you go, fastboot, Flash Recovery. Recovery. Space. Recovery. Dot image. Of course, it was gone. So now we're gonna do the same thing again. Power, volume up. And then fast boot. Reboot. Okay. Enter and power together. So enter and then power. Volume up, of course. Keep holding volume up. Don't press these buttons too hard. Big zoom in my face. There we go. We are in Twerpo. Hello, my friend. How are you doing? So what we're now going to do is, let me see my downloads. Please, 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 man. Lineage OS 4 Pine. That is this baby here, Pine. Copy. We go to the internal. We say paste, plaque. Plaque, my friend. This is what they call plaque. Paste and plaque. Well. And this is the only, the right way to do it, eh? So, you cannot do this from out MIUI 11. You must first downgrade to MIUI 10. And then, you know, you can go do the whole thing again. Flash twerp, etc. So you're going to be flashing twerp two times. So now we're just going to do advanced wipe, Dalvik system, fender, data, catch and custom. We flash the ruiten met uit. Okay, now we're going to hit install. Lineage OS 17, Pine. Gonna go to wipe and we're gonna do a format data and we're gonna type yes. And now we're gonna reboot the system, do not install. And now our beautiful Lineage OS will boot up on the Redmi Note 7. So that is an amazing thing. We can flash images. This thing can take images. So that's as well kind of cool. And we just updated to Android 10. I can say congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. You just updated your Redmi 7A to Android 10. Jawel. And it's already booted up. There it is. Hello, Lineage OS. Oh, I get error. What is this? Qualcomm Crisp Stop States. Why? Oh, this is not good. Oh my goodness. What was that error? I hope that error never comes again. And there we are, baby. Now I can go ahead and show the complete Lineage OS, but the Lineage OS is not that good because I cannot connect to my MTP in some way. So I decided to install an official custom ROM, and the best one out there is Moki OS. MK9 Pine. So, but there's a problem, as you could see. we are getting these red lines. So why is that? Let me show you what you should do to fix the Moki ROM so you can install it from Outwerp.
Okay, there we are. Here you can see the Moki 9 and I as well got the Moki 10. And here is the Moki 10. Up here you will find, if you open it, the zip archive, you're gonna find a compatibility zip archive. Just right mouse click and delete it. You can do that with WinRAR, very easy, and just delete it. Okay, and then just close it. Now you just fixed the nightly. The same thing I did with MKEY 9. As you can see in here, that archive is not available. So in fact, this is the fixed ROM. So this is effect, I should rename it. It's fixed. Fixed. Okay, and this one is as well fixed. This is a nightly. Fixed, hoppa. So now, effect, yeah, it's very easy. Now you can go ahead and install, Moki 9. Just go into the recovery and flash it, and after you're done, you're gonna not have this, but you're gonna have a system that you can make just like this. It's a lovely lovely system. As you can see, I already installed some applications. I did that via the Aurora store, and in fact I have a complete setup that I showed in my previous video, the Andy video, for those that saw it. With only the browser, you can go get Aurora store, and from there you can do a world of things and set up your complete system the way you want. You see, even have my KineMaster installed, my power amp. And something that you need to know about this phone is that it has a very good DAC built in. DAC is the digital analog converter that we find in these phones, and it's really amazing. This phone can play 24 bits sound at 196 kilohertz. Wait, let me show that to you. Output. Here you can see high resolution output. 24 bit sound. Yeah, if you're gonna connect it to the, if at least here you select the wired headset to, you know, to use this output, then you're gonna have 24 bit sound, 96 to 192 plus kilohertz. You know, that's why the sound of this phone is that good. So this is a phone that audiophiles, yeah, effect would love, because you will get great experience if it comes up to music out of this phone. However, you will then need power amp, at least a tool that can, you know, that can select these components to do whatever you wish it to do, and then boom, you're set and you're done to go. And I can tell you that Moki is really a lovely ROM. Here you can see Moki 9, and we could update it to Moki 10. You know, I can show you that the ROM that we just fixed, that it works fine.
off. I think this is a very, very nice RAM. Unfortunately, not working, as I could see, really fast. But things as camera, your phone, and so, deny. Got it. Pictures work. You can make videos. No errors. Selfie camera works. Yo, 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 yo. There you go. So it works fine. Okay, so this was, I think this is the best upgrade that you can do for this phone. It's a cheap phone, so yeah, you don't really have to worry too much about, hey, I'm deleting videos there. It's not a very expensive phone, so you cannot lose too much, okay? And you can always use this as a phone to play with and to test Android 10 versions, GSIs, and all these things. They are all supported. This is ARM 64AB, okay? So you need AB GSIs. So yeah, I say Moki, great work. I love the RAM. And one more thing, battery life from this RAM of this RAM is amazing, okay? So your battery life will be really, really good. And I like that. I really like that from this RAM. Because I've been testing it for 24 hours, at least the Android 9. That one had a very good battery life. I can always downgrade back if I don't like Android 10, but for what I see now, I really do. I love the icons. Yeah, I see innovation. I see colors that I don't see in other ROMs. You know? It's lovely. A nice clock. Allow clock to set clear alarm, of course. Nice stopwatch. Lovely. So this is it. Now I sure hope that you managed to do this all that I showed in the video, and that you as well updated and upgraded your Redmi 7A. If you think that this video was a good video, leave it a thumbs up, okay? To all my friends in China, etc. You know, big up. Nice phone, good work. Xiaomi, I really love it. And I heard you guys saying the other day that Samsung and iOS, Apple iPhone can soon pack and leave. If I see your 89 euro phone, then I think you're making a good chance to let that happen. But be quiet about it, because you know how it goes. You know, when some people don't like that, you yourself know. Look what happened to Huawei. Although with Huawei is a little bit different. Huawei is not unlocking the bootloader, so let's not talk about Huawei. Let's leave Huawei out of this. Because Huawei effect is a big disappointment, that we cannot unlock the bootloaders, so we cannot install other firmware, and we are bounded to MIUI 11. Because I think MIUI 11, I'm gonna be really honest with you guys, honest from my heart, what I saw from that operating system is that it's effect abusing the rights from the people. You know, if there was some rights organization out there, you know, they would surely talk to MIUI to change that. You know, it's ridiculous that people cannot turn off applications in the ROMs that you guys are pushing to the people. The MIUI 11, it's terrible. You know, you cannot disable any application. You want to change a background, you must give permission to the application to use your phone and things like that. You know, it's not clear with MIUI what it's really doing, you know. But maybe that's how Chinese firmware must be. Maybe it's the government that, you know, wants it to be that way. So I'm not gonna complain about that or even judge about that. Only thing I can say is that everyone that has this phone is better off with Moki or with, you know, another custom ROM that at least has the rights that respect the users. That was it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. This was Puk. I'm signing out and stay well.